हेलो टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 7, एसी करंट एक्सरसाइज सम। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। व्हाट द क्वेश्चन वांट टू आस्क अस, अ 100 ओम रेजिस्टर, हियर वी हैव गिवन 100 ओम रेजिस्टर is connected to a 220 volt and 50 hertz. Okay, what 100 ohm resistor, 220 volt and 50 hertz AC supply, what is the RMS value of current? So what we have to find current. Okay, what is the net power consumed over a full cycle? So how we can deduce the answer? All right, so first of all let us draw the whole scenario here. Resistor is connected with 100 ohm resistor is connected with 220 volt 50 hertz supply. Now as we know omega is equal to 2 pi f 2 pi 3.14 f 50. So (50)/2, that means 100 multiply 3.14, so omega 314 radian per second, so we get the answer of omega. So omega, that is 314 radian per second. Now first of all we want to find current, so I is equal to V over R. Okay, V, that is given to you 220. Okay, R also given to you, that is 100, so 220 by 100, that is 2.2 ampere. So value of current we deduce 2.2 ampere. Now second, what is the net power consumed over a full cycle? Here we can see on the resistor is connected with AC power supply, so phase difference between voltage and current, phi is equal to 0, hence consumed power P is equal to V I cos phi. V, that is 220, I, that is 2.2 cos 0, that means 22 multiply 22, 484 watt, because cos 0 1 22 by 10 करेंगे तो 0 0 कैंसिल, 22 मल्टीप्लाई 22, सो आंसर 484 वॉट। ये आपका फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन का आंसर आ गया। नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस द सेकंड क्वेश्चन। ओके, नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड क्वेश्चन। क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दिस, द पीक वोल्टेज, peak voltage of an AC supply is 300 volt. What is the RMS voltage? Okay, the RMS value of current in AC circuit is 10 ampere. What is peak current? So here let us discuss what we have given and what we want to find. पीक वोल्टेज मीन्स मैक्सिमम वोल्टेज. सो मैक्सिमम वोल्टेज वी मैक्स 300 वोल्ट. वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड वी आर एम एस और ओनली वी. समटाइम्स ओनली वी इट मीन्स दैट वी आर एम एस. ओके इन सेकेंड आई आर एम एस इज गिवन टू यू दैट इज 10 एम्पियर एंड वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आई मैक्स मीन्स पीक वोल्ट करंट. सो इट इज वेरी इजी डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू फाइंड. सो एज वी नो दैट VRMS is equal to Vmax over root 2. Here we have given Vmax, that is 300 over root 2, 1.414. So now divide 300 upon 1, divide 300 by 1.414. So value should be 212.1 volt. You can deduce it with your calculator. With the help of calculator you can define the value. Now okay, IRMS is equal to IM over root 2 or IMAX over root 2. That means IM is equal to root 2 IRMS. Alright, so IM root 2 means 1.414 into IRMS, that is 10 ampere given to you. So answer should be 14.14 ampere or 14.1 ampere. Both the value same, 14.14 or 14.1. Dono sahi answer hai aapke beta. Chale. We're going to discuss question number 3. Now let us discuss question number 3. A 44 millihenry inductor, 44 millihenry inductor is connected to 220 volt and 50 hertz AC supply. Determine RMS value of the current in the circuit. Okay, so here we have given inductor L 44 millihenry, VRMS or V 220 volt, F 50 hertz, that means omega 2 pi F 3.14 50, that is 314 radian per second. Okay, now L is connected with AC source. Okay, so first of all we have to find XL, that is inductive reactance, omega L, omega 314 L 44 millihenry, matlab divide by 1000. So 314 upon 314 multiply 44 upon 1000. So answer should be 13.8160. Okay, now current I V over XL, V that is 220, XL 13.816. So 220 divided by 13.816, that gives you 15.9235 ampere. 15.9235 ampere. This is your answer. Now let us discuss question number 4. Okay, now what is question number 4? A 60 microfarad capacitor, 60 microfarad capacitor is connected to 110 volt and 60 hertz AC supply. determine the RMS value of current. So let us draw first of all figure. Here you can see capacitor is connected with AC supply. Okay, now current is passing. Okay, so here see 60 microfarad. Okay, voltage RMS voltage 110 volt, frequency f that is 60 hertz, so omega that is 2 pi f means 120 into 3.14, so answer should be 376.8 radian per second. Now for only capacitor XC 1 over omega C, XC that is 1 over omega C, 1 upon omega that is given to you, we find so value of the omega is 376.8 multiply 60 microfarad, that means 10 raised to minus 6, so we can write it as 10 raised to 6 over 378.6 multiply 60, yani ki 10 lakh divide by 378.6 divide by 60, so answer should be 44.02 ohm, that means 44 ohm. Now I is equal to V over XC, V that is 110 upon XC that is 44, so 110 divided by 44, answer should be 2.5 ampere, that's it. Now let us discuss question number 5. What it says in previous question 3 and 4, what is the net power absorbed by each circuit over a complete cycle, explain your answer. Okay, in question number 3 only inductor is given. Okay, so only inductor is given, hence phase difference between voltage and current phi is equal to pi by 2, so power P is equal to V I cos phi, means whatever the answer value should be 0, because pi by 2 cos pi by 2 0, so whole answer is 0, so that is 0 watt. Okay, in question number 4 only capacitor is given, hence phase difference between voltage and current that is minus pi by 2, so P VI cos phi VI cos minus pi by 2, because cos is a even function, it absorb the negative sign, it becomes cos pi by 2 and value of cos pi by 2 is 0, hence power consumed by a circuit that is 0 watt. So in both the case power consumed by circuit is 0 watt. Now let us discuss question number 6. What it says, according to question number 6, obtain the resonant frequency omega r of a series LCR circuit with L2 Henry, C32 microfarade and R10 ohm. What is the Q value of the circuit? So first of all, let us find omega R. Resonant frequency omega R can be find by the equation omega R is equal to 1 over root LC. So 1 root L, L that is 2, C that is 32, 10 raised to minus 6. Dear students, please keep it in your mind, if power is even, then and then only took square root. If power is odd, try to make it even and then find the value of square root. So here it is 1 over 32, 2's are 64, 10 raised to power minus 6. So it becomes 1 over 8, 10 raised to power minus 3. 10 raised to minus 3, that means 1000 over 8. 1000 over 8, that is 125 radian per second. So we get the first answer of omega. Now we want to find quality factor. Okay, to find value of quality factor, we have equation Q is equal to 1 over R root L by C. 1 over R root L by C, let us put the value. So 1 by 10 root L, that is 2, 32, 10 raised to minus 6. So that is 1 by 10, okay, 1 over 32 means 16, 10 raised to minus 6. So we can write it as 1 by 10, 1 by 4, 10 raised to minus 3. That means 1000, because 10 raised to minus 3 upside, 10 raised to plus 3. 10 multiply 4, 100 by 4, that is 25. So value of the quality factor is 25. Now let us discuss question number 7. Okay, now let us discuss question number 7. What it wants to ask? Okay, a charge 30 microfarad capacitor. Capacitor value is given 30 microfarad, is connected to 27 millihenry inductor. Okay, C 30 microfarad, L 27 millihenry. Okay, what is the angular frequency omega of the free oscillation? That means omega 0. Okay, that means we want to find the resonant frequency. So equation omega 0, 1 over root LC, 1 root L, 27, 10 raised to minus 3, see 30, 10 raised to minus 6. See, dear students, here you can see that power become odd, minus 3, minus 6, that is minus 9. मैंने आपको पहले ही बताया बेटा कि कभी भी पावर हो वो ऑड नहीं होना चाहिए, इवन रखो. तो ये हो जाएगा 27 मल्टीप्लाई 3, 10 रेस टू माइनस 8. सो नाउ इट बिकम्स इवन, क्योंकि 30 का मैंने 3 कर दिया तो 10 रेस टू माइनस 5, 10 रेस टू माइनस 3 यानी 10 रेस टू माइनस 8. ओके, ये हो गया 9, 10 रेस टू माइनस 8. आपको लगेगा सर क्यों ऐसे? अच्छा, 27 मतलब 9, 3 इज़ 27 और ये 3, सो 3 इंटू 3 वापिस 9, सो 9 इंटू 9, 10 रेस टू माइनस 8. सो इसको लिखा जाता है 1 अपॉन 9, 10 रेस टू माइनस 4. अच्छा, 10 रेस टू माइनस 4 ऊपर जाएगा तो इसको लिख सकते हैं 10 इंटू 10 रेस टू 3 ओवर 9, 10 बाई 9 दैट इज 1.1 इंटू 10 रेस टू 3 रेडियन पर सेकेंड. तो ये आपका एंगुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी या फिर रेजोनेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी हो गया. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. Suppose the initial charge on the capacitor given in question number 7 is 6 millicoulomb. So charge that is given 6 millicoulomb. That means 6 into 10 raised to minus 3 coulomb. What is the total energy stored in the circuit initially? So E total. Okay. What is the total energy at the later time? Okay. So here, first of all, for the capacitor, only electrical energy is stored. So equation Q square by 2C. Q means 6 into 10 raised to minus 3 square 2. Capacitor value 30 microfarad. That means 10 raised to minus 6. So 6 square, that is 36. 10 raised to minus 6 upon 2 into 30 and 60, 10 raised to minus 6. So that is cancel. So energy is 0.6 joule. Energy E, that is 0.6 joule, because 6 6 are 36 and 6 10 are 60. So 6 by 10, yani 0.6 joule. Now, when inductor is connected, then some energy is stored in inductor also, but the total energy of the circuit remains constant, 0.6 joule. Okay, so this is your answer. Initial and final value should be same, but when inductor is connected, then there is some change in value energy stored in capacitor and value of energy stored in inductor. Now let us discuss question number 9. A series LCR circuit with R is equal to 20 ohm, L 1.5 Henry and C 35 microfarad is connected to a variable frequency 200 volt AC supply. When the frequency of the supply equals to the natural frequency of the circuit, what is the average power transferred to the circuit in one complete cycle? Okay, now here this is your L, C, R, AC series circuit. Value of L, that is 1.5 Henry. C, that is 35 microfarad. The R, that is 20 ohm. Okay, in this particular question, we have given that frequency of the supply equals to natural frequency of the circuit. That means here we are talking about resonance condition. At resonance condition, XC is equal to XL, hence impedance Z is equal to R. So I is equal to V over Z. 200 Z means R, that is 20, so 10 ampere. Now power P is equal to V into I. Okay, so value of V, that is 200 multiply I, that is 10, so 2000 watt, because at resonance cos phi is equal to 1. So here I don't put cos phi because its value is 1. So 200 into 10, that is 2000 watt is your answer. Now let us discuss question number 10. In this particular question we have given A radio can tune over the frequency range of a portion of megawave broadcast band, 800 kilohertz to 1200 kilohertz. If its LC circuit has an effective inductance of 200 microhenry, what must be the range of its variable capacitor? Here we have given 800 kilohertz and F2, 1200 kilohertz, also L, that is 200 microhenry. Okay, as we know, F is equal to 1 over 2 pi root LC. Okay, that means F square is equal to 1 over 2 pi L, sorry, 4 pi square, because squaring. Okay, so from that C is equal to 1 over 4 pi square L F square. Now just substitute the value, so we get C1 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi square L F1 square. Let us substitute all the values. So 1, 4, 3.14 square value of L. L, that is given to us 200 microhenry. So 200 into 10 to the 2 minus 6 upon F1, that is 800 kilohertz. That means 10 to the 3 square. Okay, so 1 upon 4, 3.14 into 3.14, 9.8596. Okay, now 2 into 10 raised to minus 4, okay, that is 64 into 10 raised to 10, because 2 or a 3, 10 raised to 5 square, 10 raised to 10. चले ठीक है, तो ये हो जाएगा 1 डिवाइड बाय 4 डिवाइड बाय 9.8596 डिवाइड बाय 2 डिवाइड बाय 64, दैट मींस 1.98 10 रेस टू द पावर माइनस ओके 4, और यहाँ पर माइनस 4 प्लस 10 यानी 6 ऊपर जाएगा तो माइनस 6, तो दैट इज 1.98 10 रेस टू माइनस 10 राइट फेराडे, दैट मींस 198.09 पिको फेराडे, बिकॉज 2 पॉइंट इस तरफ गए तो माइनस 12 हो गया, तो दैट इज 198.09 पिको फेराडे. चले उसी तरह से C2 इज इक्वल टू 1 ओवर 4 पाई स्क्वायर एल एफ टू स्क्वायर. चले वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट करते तो 1 अपॉन 4 3.14 स्क्वायर 2 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 4 एफ 1200 यानी 12 इंटू 10 रेस टू 5 स्क्वायर. चले तो ये हो जाएगा 1 डिवाइड बाय 4 डिवाइड बाय 9.8596 डिवाइड बाय 2 डिवाइड बाय 144. सो 8.804 10 रेस टू पावर माइनस 5 माइनस 4 10 यानी माइनस 6, तो दैट इज 88 पिको फेराडे. तो यहाँ पर आपकी जो रेंज है इट इज़ फ्रॉम 198 पिको फेराडे टू 88 पिको फेराडे. ये आपकी आंसर्स हो गए. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. Now let us discuss question number 11. Figure shows a series LCR circuit connected to a variable frequency 230 volt source. L that is 5 Henry, C that is 80 microfarad, R that is 40 ohm. First, determine the source frequency which derives the circuit in resonance. Second, obtain the impedance of the circuit and the amplitude of current at the resonating frequency. And the third, Determine the RMS potential drop across the three element of the circuit shows that the potential drop across the LC combination is zero at the resonating frequency. Alright, so first of all, let us substitute value what we have given. Here voltage V, that is 230 volt. Alright, L, that is 5 Henry, C, that is 80 microfarad, R, that is 40 ohm. Alright, first we have to find the omega R root LC L 5. See, that is 80 into 10 raised to minus 6. Okay, power is on, so we can take direct 5 into 80, that is 400, 10 raised to minus 6. Okay, 400, that is 20, 10 raised to minus 6, 10 raised to minus 3, that is 1000 by 20. So answer should be 50 radian per second. So we get the omega R. Now second, what we want to find, obtain the impedance of the circuit and the amplitude of the current. Okay, at resonance, XC is equal to XL, hence Z is equal to under root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square. That means Z is equal to R. Okay, so impedance should be 40 ohm. Now current, I is equal to V over R, V, that is 230, R, that is 40. So 230 by 40, that is 5.75 ampere. Now that is the RMS. So I max is equal to root 2 I, that means 1.41, 5.75. So answer should be 8.13 ampere maximum current. Now option number 3, the potential drop across L means inductor. So V L is equal to I into XL, that means I into omega L. Just substitute the value, I, that is 5.75, omega, that is 50, L, that is 5. So answer should be multiplication of three of them should be 1437.5 volt second. Potential drop across C, this is equal to IC multiply XC. So 5.75 omega, 50 C, 80 microfarad, 80 into 10 raised to minus 6. So answer should be 14. Okay, now potential drop across R, so V is equal to IR. Okay, I, that is 5.75 multiply R, that is 40. So 5.75 into 40, that is 230 volt. Okay, also combination of LC, VL minus VC, that is 1437.5, that is 0 volt. Hence the value of V, that is 230 volt. That's it. So we get the final answer.